Hello and welcome back for the first time to Master Dungeon, what I'm gonna be calling my D&D stuff on this channel. I find myself right now having a lot of D&D creative energy, and I'm not actively running a campaign right now, so I have nowhere to put it. So I'm giving it to you. I've decided that I'm gonna go through the Monster Manual in order and create a dungeon slash adventure, because they're kind of the same thing, for each monster in here. An adventure you can use yourself, or maybe just seeing the monster the way that I see it might inspire you to create it the way that you see it. We'll be starting on page one, Aarakocra. Honestly, I forgot that Aarakocra were in here, so when I saw this bird guy, I was like, haha, I got nothing. But fortunately, the Monster Manual has words in it as well as pictures, which sometimes I forget. So when in doubt, we can dive into it for inspiration. Let's see this first paragraph. Blah, 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 blah. Protect their windy borders against elemental plane of earth, such as gargoyles, their sworn enemies. Sworn enemies? Now that's something I can work with. And now I can stop reading. Birds having sworn enemies? That reminds me of the levels Zephyr and Breeze Harbor from Spyro, Ripto's Rage. Now I have something that I can rip off, and I'm ready to go. So in those levels, there's a war between birds and these slug things. So we'll have a war between the air elemental side and the earth elemental side. Why are they fighting? I don't know, maybe the birds like blue and the slugs like gray, so they're just too different to ever get along. Well, if we read a little bit further down, it says that these birds are always on the search for the rod of seven parts. So maybe they're both fighting over a part of the rod of seven parts. What does the rod of seven parts do? Historically, it is a rod that gives you more magical power-ups the more pieces of a rod that you have, and it's like the rod of law, and it makes you more lawful for having it. But I don't think that really fits. Why would the earth elementals want that? Honestly, why do the birds even want that? But that's fine, we can adapt that. It can do that cool stuff, and if you have all seven parts, it becomes a key to the city of Sigil. Sigil is the city with doors to all the other planes. That would be a huge advantage for somebody trying to take over the other planes. Elemental planes are trying to spread out and are constantly at war with each other because they cancel each other out. You know, Pokemon? Note to self, Sigil would be a really good campaign setting. Great! For the purposes of this exercise, Aarakocra are going to be kind of like the featured enemy, so we'll design around being on the Earth side. Plus, then we can have a Galabdor NPC, and I mean, look at this guy. Look at this friendly guy. When you actually put a choice between two factions in front of the players, they're probably going to decide which one they actually like better, depending on if you keep it gray or not. But also from my experience, people like to know what the right choice is, which will sometimes lead to the PCs asking about minimum wage and health benefits of each opposing army before deciding which one is the right choice. So let's speed that up. Now, keeping it gray and open is great for you, but I'm trying to make these things as condensed as possible, like probably run it in a day sort of thing. And if you give them the option to explore their options, they'll explore their options. Alright, the party needs to cross this mountain range where this war is happening. Get them. And the air side on top of the mountain assumes that anybody coming through the pass is on the earth side, the landies. So, as they approach the mountain, the earth army will intercept and be like, hey, it's really dangerous. The air side is gonna attack you if you go up there. But we have to cross the mountain. The princess is trapped over there and promised tomorrow. Well then, if you're willing to, we could work together to get you across the mountain. Cool. Now, stealing from Spyro again, I want to take the cannon mechanic in those levels and add it in here somehow. So why will we need a cannon? Well, in the center of our dungeon, there's going to be an out bridge, and there's going to be a rock that patrols that area. And by rock, I mean rock, not rock. Rocks are very big, so if you bring in a cannon, you don't have to be quite so high level to deal with it. Okay, how do we get the cannon halfway through the dungeon? We could either whimsically have it have legs, or earth elementals are really strong, so they could probably just carry a big thing like that up there. So then we have a cannon to deal with the rock while we figure out how we're going to cross the out bridge. If the PCs can't come up with anything, especially considering that earth elemental guys are probably very heavy, one of the earth shamans can cast like wall of stone and create a temporary bridge over it. Well, how do we get to the bridge then? How about a series of underground tunnels that are being excavated to try and find the part of the rod of seven parts? That way over on this side, the earth elementals will have the advantage because the flying guys won't be able to fly anywhere because it's contained and inside of a tunnel. And over here, we'll have some Aarakocra scouts who are just kind of searching for the part, trying to find the right tunnel. They're busy looking around. That way, you will be able to get the drop on them if you so choose. And because they're outnumbered, they'll just try to get out of there and warn others of your approach. Yeah, I've seen a Matt Colville video. So, after the bridge, we should give the birds more of an advantage. What if it's a big, long, exposed switchback up the mountain? Here, the birds will have the advantage of their flight, which they will use to drop bombs or boulders down from the top of the mountain onto the people coming up from above. From below. And when we finally get to the top, who will the boss be? Air elementals! So when you get to the top, there's this mountain camp where there's already an air elemental, so the earth platoon you came up with will go and keep that one occupied. That way, the PCs can focus on the Arakakra up there. Reading down here again, it says that 5 Arakakra can do a summoning dance to bring an air elemental into this plane. So, that's what they're doing. If they succeed in bringing another air elemental into the fight, then they'll definitely be able to overwhelm the earth platoon and make it the PC's problem. So we'll have a tactical combat where lots of people are trying to keep the PCs away from interrupting the dance. Win condition, they stop the dance, they don't have to deal with an air elemental, earth platoon easily beats the air side. But if they fail, then they'll have to really deal with an air elemental of their own, which, depending on their level, might be really hard. Hooray! The Earth Platoon has captured this checkpoint, which means that they can guarantee your safe passage across the rest of the mountain, PCs get where they need to be going on time, and they made allies along the way. And let's add in a little twist. Somewhere over here, let's add in a fork in the road. Over here, this corridor will lead to a Temple of Elemental Evil, aka where the part of the Rod of Seven Parts is that they're all looking for. Now that temple is probably above the PC's pay grade, and prom is still tomorrow, so they don't have time to get distracted. This just opens the door for them if they want to revisit this area and these allies in order to go dungeon diving. And notably, it's probably not a good idea for the Earth Elemental Army to have the Rod of Seven Parts either, which will lead to conflict down the way. Or maybe not. Maybe the PCs want all of reality to be inside of a rock because they help bring it about, which means that they'll get a sweet deal out of it. Honestly, good job, me. This wasn't just a dungeon. This is a setup for a big adventure. This could be the whole campaign. Like a campaign of the Rod of Seven Parts and the Temples of Elemental Evil. They should make a pre-constructed adventure like that. If anything I mentioned sounds like a pre-made adventure, I didn't mean to, this all just came up from my brain in a day. Notably, I once ran a campaign all about giants at the same time that Storm King's Thunder came out, and I never opened that book. So there we go, an Arakakra adventure. I love this one, I kinda wanna run it ASAP. I'd say to make Arakakra the actual featured enemy, you should probably make it for PCs level 4 or lower. That also limits access to the spell Fly, so that they can't just fly over the mountain. This, of course, can still be run for higher levels than that. The Earth Platoon will just have to help out less so that they have to deal with the rock and the air elementals more. Or you could lean hard into no side is completely correct angle and have the PCs come and go as diplomats between the two armies. The next monster up is the Aboleth, which is a challenge rating 10 really big fish. So we'll have a bigger fish to fry next time. Or the Earth Platoon will defeat their element. That's hard to say.